you grow up as a mixed race person, you know what it means to not fit in. As a mixed person, you're always kind of like, who am I? What am I really? Because you can't define it. You know, a couple of times you do get a little bit frustrated, you know, when you have to tick that box or people ask you, what are you? Because what is racial identity anyway? Is that just strictly the color of your skin? I never really noticed the difference between my parents' skin color. My parents would always tell me, Michael, you are half British, half Ugandan. I got pictures that I drew when I was 5 or 4 years old, and I drew my whole family in white, because I just didn't see the difference. So, skateboarding, I got involved in when I was 10 years old. Everyone I skated with was white. Being the only black guy, I had all these white friends, and skateboarders, they like to mess around at the expense of others. So I was always at the end of the black jokes. You know, look, we can go get some fried chicken. You love that. You're gonna love that. Like, why am I gonna like fried chicken? Why, guys? Hey guys, let's take a break from skateboard and play soccer. Michael, you're good at that. What? Why am I good at soccer? Why would I, you know? And okay, those are the lighter ones, but there were some heavy ones which sort of bleaked me out of it. Even the fact that the jokes were referring to me as a black person, like, in essence, I'm not a black person, I'm half a black person. It was kind of like they were missing my identity. It's time for you to seize the day. There was a friend of mine who was a next door neighbor, white guy. His father came and knocked on the door and like told him, said, no, boy, you're not staying at this person's place. I only found out later that, yeah, it was actually his father didn't want his white son interacting with a mixed family or black family or whatever you want to call it. I think it has been an issue, my skin color. It has been an obstruction to girls liking me. There's this one girl, I was told by another friend of mine that she liked me. It was like over a space of a week, she was told by her friend, you know, what are you doing? Like, he's, you know, he's not white. That hurt, you know, it was kind of like, you know, what the heck, like, you know, that, yeah, and it kind of, if it gets you, it gets you. One of the questions that come up, what do you tick in the box? What do you tick in the box? Definitely don't fit in a white box. In most cases, you fit in a colored box, at least at face value, and you could fit in the black box as well. But at the same time, you don't fit in those boxes. I came to UCT, and then bam, most of my friends are, you know, black Indian, I'm Nepalese. I've got a very mixed group of friends, and I think that's where I'm most comfortable. The scholarship program I'm on is the Alan Gray Orbis Foundation. Do I count as someone of color? You know, as you engage in those things and you sort of think about them, it's a little bit hard. You get the job not necessarily because you're the best, but because they need to fill it in. You know, it's kind of like an insult to your competency. How would you feel about you being employed based on the fact that you're not white? My scholarship program covers my residence, tuition, books, and pocket money. My parents are saving by sending me to university. The sport I've been getting involved in now is basketball. It's pretty clear that basketball is definitely mostly a black sport. Every time I play basketball, it's pretty much with just black people. I don't feel I stand out as much when playing basketball as I do when I'm skateboarding. You notice the white guys playing basketball, you'd be like, you know, oh, black colored, Asian, white, what? White guy, what's he doing playing basketball? I got a picture of myself when I was 3 years old, holding a ball, slam dunking. I've never experienced any ridicule from the black guys. Never. For being mixed race or not fully black. Nobody actually has ever called me a coconut, funny enough, and which you would think they they would, you know, because you hear my voice and the way I speak and you're like, you know, what's this white person doing trapped inside this person's body? You know what I mean? What do you have in common with mixed race people? I think it's just that knowledge that they like you. You know, that they come from like the same or similar sort of background as you. You might have different interests, but it gives you a sense of identity, a sense of I'm part of something else, you know, like I'm not on my ace. It's kind of cool when you meet them, because before actually meeting them, you know that they're mixed race and from first generation. I don't know, you can just see it. And you know, once you get talking, it's just kind of like there's this mutual understanding already, because you know exactly what it's been like. This is still a struggle. Just give me a moment on this one. Not to the extent that it was. It used to be. It used to really be a struggle. Like, I know who I am. I live my life interacting with people of very different races, like, and very comfortably. Whereas a lot of people are sort of still kind of set in their ways, they're kind of comfortable. In a sense, I'm swimming upstream, like I'm heading a different direction, like at least a more proactive direction towards, you know, a non-racial way of life. It's time for you to seize the day.